Are you ready to supercharge your SwiftUI development? For a limited time, I'm offering an 85% discount on my entire product bundle designed to help you code faster and smarter. Yes, that includes Navigation Coordinator too. Whether you're looking to streamline your workflow or build stunning apps with ease, this bundle has everything you need. Don't miss out on this exclusive offer. The discounted link is down in the description. Navigation Coordinator is a part of our summer sale. Go ahead and check out the 85% discount link in the description. So, today we are going to talk about how I extended Navigation Coordinator. This was a request from one of my users, and it's really simple. How to use Navigation Coordinator together with TabView. And unfortunately, it wasn't in Navigation Coordinator, but now, as of version 4.0.3, it is. So let me just show you what the actual kind of problem is. You know, we can just use these tabs to just navigate between them. Like if we click over here, you can just navigate through the tabs. But we would like to switch the tabs. And I'm clicking right over here. It's doing nothing, of course, because we are going to implement it today. But clicking on this switch tab to Apple View and also switch tab to Tomato View would, in fact, switch tabs. And yeah, this is what we added into, well, I added into Navigation Coordinator. And this is what we are going to learn today how to use. And I'm going to use the demo project for this. It's together with the product. So this is how it looks currently. So we have the tab view, we have navigation route for the apple and tomato and grapes. By the way, go ahead and check out the link in the description for version 4.0.0. And that takes you through all of this. Pairing TabView with Navigation Coordinator in SwiftUI is an amazing approach because it allows for a clean, organized and scalable way to manage complex navigation flows within your app. The TabView provides a natural way to structure different sections of your app, while the Navigation Coordinator handles the intricate details of transitioning between views and managing state. This combination ensures that your app's navigation is both intuitive and maintainable. Now, this video will demonstrate just how easy it is to implement this powerful technique, making your SwiftUI development process smoother and more efficient. So, we want to have a switch tab to Tomato View and also a switch tab to Apple View. Okay, that's great, but how would we do that? Currently, we just use the navigation environment to push, for example, right over here, the banana. And we are listening to onComplete, onDismiss, all of that stuff. And also, we can just also change the link type, sheet, and all of that. So Navigation Coordinator is amazing. But how would we do that to kind of switch, navigate to the tab view? Well, let's just talk a little bit of what we have over here. We have a tab view, basically kind of a container, and we have three navigation routes. Each of them contains a navigation coordinator, which means that it has its own kind of array, kind of path of navigation. So it knows, okay, the first tab that starts with the Apple view has this and that path to some sort of other view. The tomato tab has a different one. And the grapes tab, again, a different one. So it's basically holding three navigation coordinators. If you want to switch between these three kind of navigation coordinators, it would not be possible to just access navigation, the navigation coordinator, and then switch to another navigation coordinator. So using the environment of navigation is not really available, because if we want to switch to another tab, we have a different navigation environment. So therefore, we want to have an all-encompassing environment, which will be the tab navigation already inside Navigation Coordinator 4.0.3. And That's what we are going to use. By the way, if we extend it, it's right over here. So tab navigation key, tab navigation. Yeah, you can take a look at the code. It's kind of like the same as the navigation environment, but much, much simpler. Okay, so let's get into it. All of this needs to be set up. As it is with navigation route, if you take a look at the code, you will see that there is a lot of setup there. We need to create some sort of a setup for our tab view to incorporate this newly created tab navigation environment. And that is the tab navigation route. So tab navigation route. And this requires a selection. So you can see we have selected and the content. Now, this is not the same as the tab view selection. It is not binded. We can't change it therefore. But it is of type destination. So you want to choose between the free routes of your navigation routes, what you have on inside your tab view. So I will just choose tomato. So usually, the tab view starts off with the first one that you added right over here, and that is apple. Let's just choose tomato so we can actually see that it is indeed taking effect. So let's build and run, and let's see the tab navigation route merging all of this into a tab view and actually starting off with the tomato view, the second tab, which is nice. Okay, so we still can switch between tabs if we want to, but we want to have this switch on a tap of a button too. So what to do? Let's just go into that tomato view, and there are two easy steps. So first of all, we need to access the tab navigation. It's an environment exactly the same as the navigation environment, what you can see right over here. So let's create that environment dot tab navigation. As you can see, it's popping up var. Let me just copy this out so I don't have any typos. And now that we have access to this tab navigation, we can just hit dot right over here and have this method available to us. Switch to, and it's as simple as it looks like. We want to switch to a destination. If we hit dot, we will have access to the destination array that we have set up earlier. Again, take a look at the previous video, and we can switch to, and it's Apple view. That's the first one. Please note that this is the only method that we have, and of course we need. And furthermore, this does not have an onComplete or onDismiss. First of all, tab views will not be dismissed. And second of all, onComplete is kind of useless right over here, because if we switch to another tab selection, then that navigation coordinator will take effect. So doing something else on this part of the application, this tab, it's kind of useless. So I did not add an on completion at all, or of course an on dismiss. So let's test this out. If we could switch to the Apple view, let's click on it. There it is. And just switching to the Apple view. Now, of course, on the Apple view is the same. Let me just copy out the environment. Let's just put it over there. And then you just go tab navigation dot switch to, and now it is tomato. So tomato view. Let's build and run. There we go. Switch to Apple view, switch to tomato view. And by the way, it's working combined. So let's just switch to the Apple view with the tab bar and then click on switch to tomato view. Does the same. Maybe just go over here like nuts over on the tab bar and then switch to Apple view. It just works perfectly because, of course, under the hood, this is a tab view, but now it's much more convenient, much more streamlined, one unified API. Thank you for the feature suggestion. If you bought Navigation Coordinator, feel free to report a bug if there is any, and also ask a feature request. This was made possible by a feature request, and if you like this kind of codes, Navigation Coordinator and all of that stuff, please note that we are having a summer sale, 85% discount. The link is down in the description. Just use promo code. Thank you.